Hi, everyone. I'm Anna Berry, and this is New to the Street. We are speaking with Alain Ghiai with Globex Data Limited, the leader in Swiss-hosted private and secure communications and data management. Happy to welcome you back to New to the Street, Alain. We're talking about a very important topic, fly traps. They're everywhere. They're everywhere on the internet, and they're hijacking our account through apps like WhatsApp and Facebook Messenger. Tell us, what should we be on the lookout for?
Great topic of the week. Thanks, Anna, and hello to our viewer out there who's watching our program. So fly traps are essentially, it's a metaphor for a malware that essentially captures all your information. There is one right now on Facebook and obviously WhatsApp, because it's part of the Facebook ecosystem, and they probably have them on other system. They basically capture your IP address, your name, your email, your phone number. It really starts with a phone number, because people use Facebook for everything, and they download the application. And to download the app, you need to have your phone number when you accept these application. So it starts with a phone number as a weak link. Then they have your entire life. Once they have your IP, and they have your name, and then eventually they get your passwords, et cetera, and of course your email. So now they can send you, you know, phishing email and whatnot. So once they collect that data, what they do is, and that's the fly trap. The fly trap is coming, actually. This is the collection of data. The fly trap is, hey, we have a great coupon on Netflix. Apparently, Netflix, Google AdWords, and the Euro Cup for football or soccer, as we say in the United States, the Euro Cup 2020, there was a bunch of coupons flying for voting for this. But if you get a coupon for Netflix that's going to give you, I don't know, 50% off or a free month, you're going to take it, right? Who wouldn't want a free month of Netflix? So when something is too good to be true,
It probably is.
And this is where I always go back to the human behavior, because we can't rely on machines all the time to think for us. We have the best machine in the world, which is our brain and our body, the most sophisticated machine and biotech warfare machine in the world, and thinking machine. So we need to use some of that and use critical thinking. But most people are reactive. Right, you know, it's normal. We react, we click on the free coupon, and this is when the fly trap come in, and then they invade your phone. They also invade all your contacts, and then they hack you. So whether it's your email that they're gonna steal, whether it's a credit card information that you stored in an application on the phone, you know, everybody now uses the phone to pay for things. And these applications, 99% of all applications in the world, are developed by third-party developer in faraway countries that we don't even know who developed the thing. They could have installed a malware in there too, and they're not really very secure, right?
Right. And these fly traps often come in the form of these exciting vouchers, right? Enticing vouchers. And they ask for your phone number. And that is what Secure Messenger never does. Why do you never ask for a phone number?
Yes. So Secure Messenger is unique in a way that, first of all, when you download any application, you need to put your phone number, right? You can't download an app without putting your phone number. What we do when we have our application on the Android or iOS store, our application already is kind of a separate, it sits on its own level. It doesn't hard code to the phone, because we don't store metadata. First, you go to our site, secure.com, and you register with us. There's many reasons for this, but one of them is being that the payment goes directly to us, and we basically go through a payment company called Stripe. And that way, you know, Google or iPhone don't have your payment information. That's already a good start. And then after that, you can download the app, and you're given a username and a password. When you buy it from us, you don't need to go through that phone number thing. So we don't ask phone numbers, because when you have a phone number attached to an app, hackers can get in within minutes. Whereas with us, when you use the application, nobody knows you're using it, because your phone number is not attached. And right. I think this is the difficulty that people have. It's habitual to upload all your contacts and text them or send them messages. With us, you're just going to have to go through a different step. You get the identity protection, and you get the anonymity, which is big, and nobody knows your phone number. So at least whatever you use, whatever you do on Sekur is private and nobody can see it.
So we have to become more selective with who we're sharing our information to. And break it down for me. What exactly do they do with our information? They get our phone number, our email, and boom, what happens?
So they get your phone number, your email, your IP address, your name, other information. You know, when it's Facebook, the people's lives are on Facebook. And that's another thing I would recommend. We talk about, you know, carbon neutral all the time now. It's great that we're going to basically be carbon neutral. But how about social media reduction as well? Your carbon footprint is damaging the environment, and it's good to reduce that. Now we're going to look at, you know, your social media footprint, which is damaging your own environment, because the more you post out there, the more they know about you, these machines. So once they have your phone number, they go into your contact list that you so rightfully synchronize and uploaded all the time. And now they're going to basically do the same to your contacts. That's another thing that we prevent at Sekur. So when you use Sekur Messenger, because we don't use the phone number, it's useless for you to upload your contacts with their phone and text them, because we don't use the phone number concept. So what you do is you can invite someone who doesn't have Sekur. That's another unique thing that we do. You invite them with inviting them through an email. So Bob Smith at, you know, Sekur.com, obviously if he has Sekur.com, he'll have the messenger, but let's say BobSmith@gmail.com. Okay. Bob Smith doesn't have Sekur. You want to chat with him. Well, Bob gets an email, clicks on a link, and it opens a portal. The whole communication stays in Switzerland within our server environment, never goes over the internet. So there's many levels of protection and security in that concept. Now, it's a little bit more cumbersome, but at least you can chat with someone who doesn't have the app. If you have friends that have Sekur, which is only $5 a month, by the way, they are issued, so are you. Every Sekur Messenger user is issued a Sekur number. We used to call it the SM number, but we received a lot of email. People are confused. They think we're asking about a SIM card number. So we just changed that to Sekur number. It's a 6-digit number. So you, Anna, have Sekur, I have Sekur, but I don't know your Sekur number. You're going to give it to me or I give you mine. You're going to contact me through Sekur. I still have to accept you as a contact. So I always have that last minute option not to accept you. Mm-hmm. It's basically, if you want to communicate with people that you know in full privacy and security without fear of hackers getting into your phone, you don't have much of a choice. You're going to have to use Sekur Messenger. And if somebody doesn't have Sekur Messenger, you can go to chat by invite. We have videos on our website, Sekur.com. If you go to help, FAQ, you'll see all the video guide. It's very easy to use.
I've done it myself. It is very easy and user-friendly and secure. So I appreciate that so much. Elaine, so our weekly hack is don't fall for the bait. These fly traps, they're going to get you and your information. We don't want people to fall for them. Thank you for your technology.
Thank you. Don't fall for the bait and always think twice before accepting a link or something like that, and reduce your social media footprint.
I'm doing that and it's helped my mental health a lot as well. So it works in many ways. Well, thank you so much for joining us on New to the Street, and we look forward to seeing you again next week.
Thank you, Anna, and thank you for our viewers out there. See you next week.